Good morning, and let us start our lecture again on chapter 6 and chapter 7. I would like to review the important thing about what so-called stress distribution. We have the three major or four major section that I like you guys to first remember it. Okay, the first section that we start on our study is the rectangular section, and for the structure, for example, this can drill beam. If you guys cut the beam, you will consider the free body diagram of this beam. And based upon we learned previously, after you cut the beam, you set up the X and Y reference axis, and then you put the known force acting on the structure. This is 4 kilonewton. This is 2 kilonewton. You can see the free body diagram of the beam need to have force and moment at the cutting section of AA. And based upon this, you may use very important thing that I should mention over here. It's called psi convention. On our psi convention, if you cut the beam, consider on this portion, you will see what? You will see this one as the positive moment. So based upon this, you got to set this one as the positive moment. And then the shear is downward. So for this one, the shear must be upward. Why the psi convention is important? Because the psi convention will tell us about the direction of the stress. It can be tension, compression, the shear stress is upward or downward. So everybody have the psi convention in order to have the same solution. And then based upon what we learn, we may start with very simple section. Let me start with this one, the rectangular. The rectangular or the square section is the double symmetry section. What I mean is the beam have two axes of symmetry, and under the application of the moment positive, okay, the beam will subjected to compression on the top and subjected to tension on the bottom. So you may draw the stress distribution from chapter 6. Sigma equal to moment times y over moment of inertia. So if the section subjected to the same moment, and also the section have the same cross section, the stress will distribute with the y. And as you may know, the compressive stress may be considered as the negative, and the tension is considered as the positive. So they're supposed to have one value between negative and positive, have the value of zero. You have positive, you have zero, and then negative. You have negative, and then zero, and then positive. So based upon this, the stress distribution due to the bending moment occur on the beam supposed to be in the shape like this. If you can't understand what I'm trying to explain to you, I recommend you to remember it. Okay, remember kids, if you can understand what I'm trying to teach you. And then, if the section is a kind of I section, the I section is very similar to the rectangular section in which the I section is also the double symmetry section. That means it has the vertical and horizontal axis like this. And then we got the centroid, okay, over here. And then we got this zero stress as the neutral axis. The same thing occurs. This is going to be the neutral axis. And then the stress distribution due to this equation is have the same M and I. So since you measure up and then you measure down, you get the same value. For example, 10 millimeter. And then you get this one 10 millimeter. So the stress distribution from chapter 6, the fractional stress is will be like this one and this one. And then we have another important section is the T, or the section have the, for example, this one have the flank like this. And then you have the web like this. This section is different from the I and the rectangular, in which this section is going to have only one axis of symmetry. And by doing this, the centroid of the section will not at the middle, will have chip up to the flank. So the centroid of the section is like this. And also there is another section that's similar to this one, is the C section. The C section also has only one axis of symmetry. You can see the C and the T, they are very similar, but the C have two web, the T have only one web. And based upon this one, this is the axis of symmetry. And you will have the centroid of the section here, and the neutral axis going to be on this one. Now, you will measure up, okay? This one will be C1. And then if you measure down, this is gonna be C2. And you know C2 larger than C1. So what happened is the normal stress in this case, when you measure up, it's going to be smaller than when you measure down. So based upon this one, the stress distribution on the top going to be small. On the bottom is going to be large. And due to the positive moment, on the top is in compression, and on the bottom is going to be in tension. So this is the stress, normal stress or fractional stress distribution for some important section. Now we move to chapter 7. On the chapter 7, the equation is tau equal to the same V on the section, the same V, and also the same I. Okay, an important factor is going to be Q divided by the thickness that you trying to find the tau. So it's going to be Q over T. And based upon this one, you know, for the rectangular section, you may go to direction note and you will see, since the top is going to consider first, Q is what? Q is the area, okay? area of the section above or below the given point that you determine the town. If you find the town on the top, the area over here is zero. So when the area is zero, the moment of the area will be zero. Okay, that's also occur on the bottom. And then if you consider this area, okay, this is going to be the area above the neutral axis. That's going to be the largest. Okay, and then if you time it by this moment arm, it's going to be A time time Y time. This value is going to be largest, and then you will get this point, and this point represents the tau max, and again the tau max occur at the centroid or occur on the neutral axis. And since this is the function of, for example, y cube, eh? Sorry, y square actually is going to be the function of this height times this moment arm. So this is going to be the curve in the form of parabolic curve. And then if you go to the I section, what happened is the distribution of the force on the top or the bottom going to be the same. And for this one, you may see the width of the flank is large. For example, this is 100 millimeter. So when you use this one divided by 100, the value of the stress that occur along this flank is going to be small, such as tau 1. And then when you go to the web may have only 10 millimeter. So you divide this one by 10, the value of this one will jump like 10 times. And then you may have this one for how double palm. And finally, if you consider again the moment of the area, okay, the Q, you will get the maximum Q will occur on the centroid or neutral axis. So based upon this, you will get this point as the tau max. And due to the symmetry of the section, okay, double symmetry of the section, you will get the same shape for the bottom, and then you have this one. Okay, let me illustrate this one. This is a wrong drawing of this. And then when we have this one, if you won't understand it, please remember it. Now we have the last one. It's going to be the T or the C section. And for this one, the section has only one flank. So you just copy this portion of the I section. So this is upon this one, the shear stress distribution on the top is zero. On the bottom is zero, and this is small because you are divided by the flank, and then this one jump up because you divide it by the web. So this is going to be the same. Then the same reasoning, the maximum Q will occur allow this one. What happened? What happened? I could not jump. Okay, it's going to be this one. It's going to be maximum at the centroid. So you do the same projection. Now it's going to be similar to this, not the same, similar. The maximum will go up at the centroid again, and at this point you get this one for tau max, and then there is no flat on the bottom, so the distribution of the stress of this one will curve like this. That is what we have learned from the previous lecture. Now I have a leeward K section. It's going to be on this one, and the same thing, you may use the same knowledge that we just discussed. Now the application of the knowledge, what is going to be the normal stress distribution? And if you consider this section, you will see they're giving you the y already, and that's really nice. Yes, if some problem also tough, let's say problem 2, problem 3, problem 4 is tough, Ajahn will provide you this kind of information. But I like you go back home and review how to find the centroid, and also review how to determine the moment of inertia. This one is the moment of inertia about this, what's so called neutral axis, okay, NA. And then if you measure this one, this is 70. So the distance that you measure from here to here going to be 70 minus 36.25. And for sure, you guys will get this one to be 53.75 millimeter. And you can see, based up on this, the Y measure up is going to be larger than the Y measure down. So the state on this one on top will be larger than this one. It's going to be the reverse of this, okay? But thinking about, again, the second thing, this one written basis on positive moment, and let us consider this one, we will get the negative moment. When it gets negative moment, what is going to be? Let me start, take you back to this free body diagram. This is going to be 250 millimeter, 300 millimeter, and you have the section of the cantilever beam. This is the second important beam. Typically, from the previous discussion, we have simple beam, right? The pin and the roller. And this is a cantilever beam. The support over here is fixed support, and the point over here is free end. Okay. If you go to the your dormitory, if your dormitory have the threshold, you will have the column, and then you have the threshold extrude from the column. You know the threshold, right? The beam. Okay. And then we try to do the same thing. We got to draw the body diagram of the given portion of the beam, and we determine internal shear and internal moment. Okay, let me put it just as INT, it's internal. And based upon what we have, you may get the first one, summation of F sub Y equal to zero. So let's put this one as the positive. We have what? We have V is upward, 2 is downward, 4 is downward, and the summation is zero. So we get the V equal to 6.0 kilonewton. And this V is what? This V is upward. Okay, and then for the second one, you do the summation of the moment equal to zero and take this sign convention as the positive. So you get the M rotate clockwise. You get 2 times 250 millimeter rotate in the same direction. So you have 2 kilonewton times, let's put it in meter, 0.25 meter. And then you also have the 4 kilonewton. Now it's going to times 550 millimeter. So plus 4 kilonewton and times this one, let's put it into 0.55 meter, and what you get is going to be negative moment. No, yes, it's negative moment because M is going to be equal to this term negative, and this term also negative. Just move it into the right hand side. You will get this one to be minus 2.7 kilonewton meter. And by doing this one, you may conclude that this is going to be 2.7 kilonewton meter. And the rotation of this one is going to be in the negative, right? This is going to be in the negative. This is clockwise. So this is going to be in this direction. So based upon this, actually the moment is going to be rotated like this. So the bottom of this one will be in compression, and then the top is going to be in tension, right? It's going to opposite to this one. This one due to the positive moment, this one due to the negative moment. And what is going to be our discussion? This is larger than this one. So this one supposed to be small, and this one supposed to be large. So based upon this again, this is going to be the centroid of the section. The point here will have stress equal to zero. And then the stress that you will get for this one will have a small value on the lower side, lower portion, and large value on the top. Okay. And then what is going to be the value of the stress? So our section, we determine. Determine the fractional stress. Let me put it into the full name. It's called fractional normal stress distribution on section AA. So now we have one point with the stress equal to zero. So what is going to be stress on the top? That is going to be sigma on the top surface. And as you may know, this is going to be sigma max, right? The maximum normal stress on the section. And then this is going to determine from this equation. You may take the moment. The moment is going to be this one. So it's up to you. If I prefer, I usually put this one in Newton meter, okay? And the Y now is going to be this value. So it's going to have 0.05375 meter. Convert from millimeter to meter, and then divided by moment of inertia. This is 10 power 6 millimeter power 4. and you guys know 1 meter is going to be 1000 millimeter. If you put it in powerful, this is going to be 10 power 12 millimeter powerful. So the conversion of this is going to be very small. Okay, so in the unit of meter, and you know this is going to be small, right? So it's going to be 1.78625 and 10 minus 6 meter powerful. So basis upon this, 1.78625 and 10 minus 6 meter powerful. And you can see basis upon this meter, this cut into meter square. And the unit is going to be Newton per meter square by the calculation. And then you will get sigma max basis upon this one to be 81.25 megapascal. And for sure, this one should be made by the steel. So it's supposed to be less than yielding stress of the steel of 250 megapascal. So you may say this one is going to be in linear elastic, okay? And then the distribution of this one will be linear also. Then we have the stress, this one on the bottom. Let me put this one to be stress on the bottom. And then this one will be the same number, right? It's going to be 2000 because the moment is the same. The instrument is the section is the same. 2700 Newton meter. But the measurement did now is going to be measured downward. And this is going to be 36.25 millimeter. Now this is 0.03625 millimeter and divided by the same moment of inertia, 1.78625 and 10 minus 6 meter powerful. So this one, you will get the stress smaller than the previous one. It's going to be 54.79 megapascal. So this one is 54.79 megapascal. And the top over here is going to be 81.25 megapascal. This one in compression, this one in tension, okay? And this is for the normal stress distribution. Here we come to the second one. We going to the another one for the transverse shear stress distribution. And based upon the previous discussion, we have what? We have this one is the connecting point between the fan and the web. And then this one again is going to be the centroid. And then we have zero tau on the top and on the bottom. And then the equation that we will use again based on this one, the major thing is going to be the Q and the T, okay? So based on this calculation of the Q, we use this area. And then the moment arm, we will get the Q. And for the Frank, we will use 50 millimeter into this equation. So the value of this one will be small. And again, I call this one tau ham. And then you got to divide it by 20 millimeter. So the value of the tau supposed to be 2.5 ton. Why Ajahn know about it? Because it's 50 millimeter and 20 millimeter. Okay, it's going to be 2.5. And this one will be how ham ham. And next, this one will increase a bit more because now you need to determine the cube based on the two portion of the area. So this one will increase to this point. And this is going to be the tau max. And the last one that you get, there is the web here. And the stress distribution supposed to be curved like this. Okay, that is similar to this one on the rectangular portion. Now, it is important to determine Timor stasis. So based upon this one, let me move this one up. And the third, we determine the transverse shear stress and distribution on the section AA. Okay, the shear is what? The shear is upward. When the shear is upwards, that means what? That means shear stress occur here will point up like this. Okay, will point up like this. The shear stress is going to be upward. Then we have three important points. Let me make a copy of this one. This is, let's say, 50 millimeter of the plank, and then it has 20 millimeter over here. And what we have is this one is going to be the Y bar. This is 36.25 millimeter. We start by finding the tau palm. Okay, so the tau palm will equal to the shear force that is going to be 6,000. Okay, and then it's going to time the Q. The Q for this one is what? The Q from this one will determine from the area of the flank. That is going to be 50 and time 20 millimeter. This is 0.02 meter and time 0.05 meter. That is the area. And then for the moment arm, we got to put it at the center of this one, and we measure it to the neutral axis. So what is going to be this one? This one will be 36.25 and then minus half of the thickness. So it's going to be 36.25 minus 20 divided by 2. So if you get this one, it's going to be 26.25 millimeter. That is going to be 0.02625 meter. And then you get this one for the Q. Q of what? Q of the plank area. And then you divide it by I from this equation, I and T. So you take the same I as before. So I is important. You got to find it correctly. 6.25, 10 minus 6 and meter powerful. And since it's measured on this plank, so you got to take this one to be 50 millimeter, 0.05 meter. So based upon this, this one cut, okay? And then meter, change this one to meter square. is half Newton over here. So the result going to be Newton per square meter. And then if you put it into your calculator carefully, you will get 1.763 megapascal. This is 1.763 megapascal. And then you need to determine tau double prime. Tau double prime is going to be the shear stress on the web. Okay, tau prime is the shear stress on the flank. So tau double prime is going to be the same over here. Everything the same, except only the divider. The divider will change from 50 millimeter to be the width of the web. The width of the web is what? Is 20 millimeter. So this is 20 millimeter. So everything the same. This is going to be 0.02 meter. Okay, and you need to copy everything, put into the equation. 1.786251 minus 6 meter power 4, 6,000 Newton, and the same Q. You put the same Q, you have 0.02, 0.05, and 0.2625. Then when you put it, so this one divided by 0.05, this one divided by 0.02. So this one will be 2.5 times larger than this, right? So you get this one to be 4.408 megapascal, and this one going to be 4.408 megapascal. Or you may just calculate this one is equal to 1.763 and times 2.5 times 2.5. Where is come from 2.5? This is 1.763 over here times 50 millimeter. That is the width of the flank divided by 20 millimeter. This is the width of the web. You get the same result of 4.408 megapascal. Now you got to determine the maximum, shear stress over here will occur at the centroid. You have two choices in this problem. We have to determine the Q. How max for this one is going to calculate from 6,000 Newton meter. How about the Q? If you use the bottom portion, you got to determine Q by the area of the flank and the area of the web. It's not convenient. For this type of problem, it's more convenient to use this green area. Okay, it's going to provide the same result. And then this is going to be what? This is going to be 20. And as we know from this one, this is 53.75 millimeter. So 0.05375, and then it's times 0.02. That is going to be the area. And then it's going to be the centroid of this section over here, Okay, and then we like to determine this distance. This distance going to be what? Going to be this one divided by 2. So it's going to time 0.05375 divided by 2. And then you may close your parenthesis, and then you put this one, the I is going to be 1.78625 × 10⁻⁶ meter power 4, and the width is going to be 20 millimeter, the same as this one, 0.02 meter, and then you will get the tau max to be 4.85 megapascal. This is going to be 4.85 megapascal, and see, the black is larger than the red because of the area that we use to determine the Q. Now, this is first thing you're supposed to be able to what to determine the stress distribution across this A section. There is another type of question. Okay, they're going to ask you about one thing. Let's say this is the point of B. Okay, the point of B is what? The point of B is over here at the junction, at the joint of the flank, of the flank and the web. Okay, and then they like you to draw the stress element at point B. What is going to be the stress element? Again, if you may recall, the stress element is going to be the material point at that junction. Okay, so you're going to have two element, and usually we draw it by a square and say this one is going to be B on top, B at the web, and also you have another one at the flank, so you may draw another one also the B, but it's going to be the B at the flank, so this is B as the ANTE. Okay, what we have is this point, we have the stress over here to be this value. Okay, so the stress as B, the stress as B is going to be this point. If you use this one, you also possible to find the stress as B. That is going to be sigma sub B equal to, for this bottom one, you have 2700 newton meter, the same thing. Now the y is going to be different. This one you measure from this one to this point, and for this one you only measure to this point. This is what the total is, 36.25, and the thickness is 20 − 20, so this is going to be 16.25 millimeter. So you need to put, you have to change this y bar into only this y distance. So this is 0.01625 meter my, and then divided by I, just put to be 1.78625 × 10⁻⁶ meter power 4. You will get sigma sub y bar smaller than this, and then you will get this one to be 24.56 megapascal. And if you may consider another way of this calculation, let me take you back over here. You can see this is the triangle, right? You may think this is sigma sub B. Sigma sub B divided by this length, sigma sub B. divided by 16.25. Okay, that is going to be the slope. And the same thing, the slope 54.79 divided by the y bar divided by 36.25. If you do this calculation, you will get the same sigma sub b to be 24.56 megapascal. That is another way to do so using mathematics. Okay, the triangle always has the same slope. Now we come over here. What kind of stress that we have at this point is going to be in compression, right? Yep, it's going to be in compression. So this is compressive stress. When this is compressive stress, we just put this one to be compression both on this 2 point because B at the web and B at the flank is the same Y. So this is 24.56 megapascal. This is 24.56 megapascal. And the stress is in the reference X axis. Typically, we call this one sigma sub X equal to 24.56 megapascal. Now we come to this portion. Okay, we going to take this element like this one. So the shear is upward. The shear is upward for what? For this tau palm. That is going to be upward to the flank. And we also have this one. This one is upward to the web. So the stress that we have, this is 4.4008 megapascal. This one is upward also, but it's only 1.760 megapascal. And again, you can see based upon this one, the stress is not in equilibrium. You got to have this downward, okay, to make this one in equilibrium. Then if you take the moment over here, the normal stress will cancel each other, and only this one produce the moment clockwise. So you got to have this one occur to balance the moment, this one and this one. And when this one occur, this one and this one, they are equal. So you got to have this one. And we call this to be tau sub x y. And the same thing occur here, this upward, this downward. Take the moment here, there is the shear stress like this. And also this one, this is going to be tau sub x y equal to this one. And we will use this one for the next problem, next chapter. But in reality, Ajahn will finish this one. And for the next problem, Ajahn will give you another state element, okay? In order you can have the same state element to start on the problem number two. This one, I think, going to be one of the toughest, okay, problem that you guys may solve it, okay? The section that's typically in the problem will close to this kind of section. So this is the end of two-dimension problem on chapter 6 and on chapter 7. And what I'm writing over here is the chapter 8 already. It's called, what's so called, stress combination. You combine the stress, okay, together. And then Ajahn need to move to the last portion of chapter 7. On the last portion of the chapter 7, let's us move to this one. And for a type of section that's called build up member, typically for the build up member, you will need to put, for example, a small piece of wood, and then you got to tie it together, tie them together. For example, for this one, you may require to put the nail, okay, that's put to the section. So the nail will hold the small piece of wood together. And then for the plank, if you consider the plank over here, you also need to connect it by the nail. If you just don't want to put it in the form of this one, you may not use the nail, you may use the bow, okay? But most of the time when you use bow, the section is going to be rectangular. This one, you're supposed to use the nail because the width of the section is so thin, okay? And then you got to put the nail in a proper location. So in this section, it's required to determine what's so called the S. S is the spacing of the nail, or is the spacing of the bow that's put the section together. Again, if I don't like to use nail or bow to fix it, I am the polymer engineering student. I like to glue it. Yes, you can glue it, but you got to determine the stress that occur over here. What is going to be the tau, okay? And let's say if the tau is 5 megapascal, you got to go to the lab, develop the epoxy that can resist the shear stress of 10 megapascal, something like this. And then also, if you don't like to use the nail, you like to put the glue onto it. And I should say, for this joint, you need to also determine the tau. And from the previous problem, remember, the tau on the web is going to be larger than the tau on the flank. So by doing this one, you got to develop the epoxy that has the shear strength larger than the tau on the web. Remember, that is the step, the jump up of the stress. So this is one important thing. So by doing this, we need to weld or nail or weld is called welding. That's for metallurgical engineering. Okay, for civil engineering, you may get the nailing. And whatsoever, you got to determine the shear stress that occur on this point. And there are some things in this respect. We usually didn't calculate the tau, but we instead calculate the shear force, which is going to be the shear stress that move or that occur across the connected point. By doing this one, we define Q in the form of the shear stress times the thickness. So based on this, it's going to be VQ over IT, and then time T. You just take the T. So Q is going to be small Q shear force VQ over I. Okay, and that is going to be the equation that we determine the shear force. And then by this respect, you will get the shear force in the unit of kilonewton per meter. Okay, because of what? From this equation, it's kilonewton per meter square times meter. So cut, the unit is going to be kilonewton per meter. And then you use the proportion to find the spacing of the nail. So let me trying to go to the problem. And there is important section. Again, for this respect, the most important section is the T, okay? And then again, you may finding the spacing of the nail based on this shear force equation. And if you use the epoxy, again, the tau that you use is going to be which one? Tau web or tau flank again. Which one? The strength of the glue is going to be tau web. Okay, I mentioned this one time already. And there is the other section, but most of the time is not quite used in our typical normal situation. And another important thing is the I section. Okay, so the basic will come from this one. And another question we will put it in the problem is will be what we call it the coulomb. Okay, we use a small piece of wood and we glue it together. Or we may use both to connect it together like this. So let's move to the example. When finish the example, we will take a 5-minute break. From this example, we have the composite timber beam like this one. You have a small piece of wood, okay? Like I mentioned before, it's going to be easy to grow it. And then it takes very short time. When you cut it, you can put them together. The polymer engineering need to typically develop the epoxy for connect them together. If you like to use the other, again, you use more. On this problem, they use more. And you can see this is A width. And this is 2.5 A width. So this one supposed to be 0.5 A each, right? Five of them, you can get 2.5 A. And then the beam is subjected to 20 kilonewton force. The tau allow is 2.0 megapascal. Sigma allow is going to be 15.0 megapascal. They ask us to find A. So this problem is going to be the design problem. And then this is going to be in problem number 3 of the final examination. Yes, this is going to be the problem number 3. Okay, so Ajahn teach you not only problem number 1. That's for the analysis. Problem number 3 is going to talk about the design. And then if each bolt, one bolt, have allowable shear strength of 10 kilonewton, they ask us what we supposed to put the bolt onto the section, okay, with what kind of spacing. Then that is going to be what we looking for, the spacing of the bolt. And the important thing for problem number 3 is finding the Vmax and Mmax. There is only way to determine the shear max. That means you got to know the shear diagram. And also for the Mmax, you got to know the moment diagram. And most of the time, the problem will have kind of not difficult to know shear diagram and moment diagram. That's I like you guys to go back and practice on the draw of the shear diagram and moment diagram. And for this example, let me put this one to be A sub Y and this one to be A sub X. Since this one is the pin and the B is the roller, so the B has only B sub Y. Based on this, if you do the summation of X sub X equal to zero, A sub X is zero. And then for this one again, you may like take the moment over here, summation of the moment at A equal to zero, you have B sub Y. That's B sub Y gonna time. This is 4 meters. And it's going to rotate in this way, 4B sub Y. And this 4B sub Y will equal to the moment due to this one. This one will time only 1 meter. That is equal to 20 times 1. So based upon this one, you will get B sub Y equal to 20. Divided by 4, and that is going to be 5 kilonewton. And next, summation of F sub Y equal to 0, A sub Y upward is positive, plus this one, 5 equal to 20. So A sub Y is going to be equal to 20 minus 5, that is going to be 15 kilonewton. Now we come to the shear diagram, and this is 0 meter, and this is 1 meter, 1 meter, right? 1 meter, and this is going to be 4 meter. This is the X. We have three rules. If we have the force upward, delta V is positive. Remember that? And then we come to the point of A. We arrive here. We have 15 kilonewton. So this one is upward plus 15. And then for this one, W is zero. We have dV by dx equal to minus W. So the second portion, if you move along this AC, what you get is dV by dx equal to zero. What you get is the value of the shear on this portion is going to have zero slope. So the value of this one will be plus 15. So you draw the line crosses. And then you have 20 kilonewton. If the force is downward, delta V is negative. So it's going to take this one downward for minus 20 and we'll start by 15. So this is going to be minus 5. And then for the spacing between C and B, you have W equal to zero. So based upon this, dV by dx equal to zero. So this one is just to be minus 5. And then you have 5 kilonewton here. It's going to take the value of the shear here to be close to be zero. And next, for the moment diagram, we have dm by dx equal to v. And also for this one, for point A is pin, no external moment. Point B is roller, no external moment. So we know the moment on this point and this point is zero, no external moment. But if there is external moment, the moment clockwise, delta M is negative. The moment like this one will take the M positive, counterclockwise negative, clockwise is positive. And what we have next, let me put this one into the M axis. This is, if you work on this problem, use the ruler, don't draw like me, okay? I don't have the ruler in my pad. And then this is 0, this is 1, this is 4, and this is x meter. And from this equation, dm by dx equal to v over here is 15. So what we have is the slope of this one, of source one, must be dm by dx equal to positive 15, is up the hill. Okay, positive slope. And then the slope is going to be all the same. Why? Because over here, we have the v equal to 15. So the slope always the same for every point. Now, what is going to be the value of the moment over here? From this equation, we may write m at point C, this is point C, okay? Minus m at this point, this is point A, 0. And then it's equal to the positive area of the chair. It's going to be 15 times this one times 1. So m sub C is going to be 15 kilonewton meter. This is going to be 15. And then what we have is the value of the shear is just minus 5. So the slope is going to be negative downhill. Okay. And then it's going to negative up to this one to be 0. So you have dm by dx equal to minus 5. You may put this one. And at the end, I don't believe this one is going to be 0. This is going to be m sub b. This is m sub b minus this one. This one minus 15. That is the moment over here. And it's going to be the area here. It's going to be minus 5. This is minus 5 times the length 3. So m sub b will be minus 15. This one will be plus 15. It is 0. Okay. And then we got v max to be plus 15. We got m max to be plus 15 kilonewton meter. So based on this slide, you have v max and m max. In the design, we need to start with the m max, okay? Because the equation is easier. Sigma equal to my over I, okay? This is tau equal to vq over it. If you use the tau, it's going to be very harder than using this equation. The second thing, we need to start with the moment, because most of the time from the experiment, the failure of the beam is due to the bending moment more than due to the shear. So we start by the design of this section. We're going to determine the width A based on this moment of 15 kilonewton meter. So from the equation sigma equal to my over I, we get the m already, right? So this section is double symmetry. So we need to determine the moment of inertia. And due to this one, you don't need to find the centroid because it's going to be half of 2.5. Or you already know this is 1.25A. Okay, if you put it downward, it's all 1.25A is symmetry. And then this is going to be A
and time this one 2.5 a cubed divided by 12, you get the moment of inertia at the function of the air. And this is going to be your y max. You measure up or measure down the same y max.
So you put everything together. This is going to be your y max. This is moment in Newton meter. And this is I. And you need to put this one in Newton meter square. And then you get A to be 99 millimeter. Let's say it is 100 millimeter. A bit bigger is okay, right? And then this is 100. This is going to be 2.5 times 250. Now the section, this section can resist M max, what's so called safely. Okay. How about the V max? We got to check. We need to go check. Ajahn can check the tau max that occur on the neutral axis, okay, by two types of equation. One, we may find tau max equal to V, 15,000 Newton V, and also Q. Q is going to be this area times the moment arm. So it's going to this area. This area is 0.1. And this one is going to be 0.125 meter. So the area of this one will be 0.1 times 0.125. And we have to times the area by the moment arm. This is going to be 0.125 divided by 2. And then that is going to be the Q of this section. And then you have the I, okay? You have the I. I is going to be 0.1 over here. And the depth, 0.25 Q and divided by 12. And finally, the tau is occur where? The tau is occur on this width. This is going to be 0.1 meter. You may put everything. You may also use tau max equal to 1.5 V max divided by the A. This is 0.1 times 0.25. This is going to be the A. For these two equations, you will get the same result, 0.9. Okay, and it's up to Ajahn. Some Ajahn, they are easy, like me. I allow you to use this equation. But some Ajahn said, you must use tau equal to VQ over IT to find tau max. So you got to be able to use these two types of equation. And then this is less than tau allowed. Okay, it's okay. Now the section can resist the V max. And when this section can work together, we got to bolt the section together. Okay, so what is going to be the shortest distance S? Okay, and then from the shear force equation, the shear force is equal to VQ over I. I is going to be constant for this section. I is going to be this one. And then for the shear, we have the shear, two value of the shear. Let me take you back on this one. One of the shear is plus 15. One of the shear is minus 5. So which one going to produce the shortest S? Which one? We have V equal to minus 5 kilonewton and V equal to 15 kilonewton. Which one will provide the shortest S? The large
shear force always provides the shortest s. Okay, large force require a lot of bulk. When it require a lot of bulk, the s is going to be shorter. If they didn't ask you for the shortest distance, they may ask you for the longest distance. For the longest distance, you got to determine from this equation. Okay, so the q, what is going to be the q on this section? It's going to be the largest q, but don't worry. For this tarmac, the timber will taking care of all this shear stress. Okay, what is going to be next? As you may see, the distribution of the shear stress is like this. This one provides the tarmac. What is going to be the next important? The next going to be on this one. At the joist here, the shear stress is going to be smaller than tarmac, but it's required for the bolt to resist. So based upon this Q will be determined. Again, let me illustrate. Based upon the area over here, let me take this one out. We will use this area, okay, to determine the Q. And this is going to be what? This is going to be this one for 0.1. The Q is going to be 0.1. And this is going to be what? This is also 0.5A, and this is 0.5A. So the total is going to be A. It's going to be 0.1. And then what is going to be the moment arm? Now, the moment arm will measure from here to here. It's always taking around the normal axis. From here to here, this is going to be 0.5A. So this is going to be 0.05. And this is going to be half of it. This is going to be 0.025. So the moment arm is going to be 0.075. So the Q, okay, will determine from this equation, 0.1 times 0.1. And this is going to be the moment arm. This value, when you put everything, you will get the Q is going to be 86.4 kilonewton per meter. 1 meter, that is the shear of 86.4 kilonewton. Each bolt can take 10 kilonewton. So you can use the proportion. 86.4 occur in 1 meter. Each bolt can take 10 kilonewton. So the spacing is going to be 10 times 1 meter divided by 86.4. It's going to be 0.116 meter, or it's going to be 116 millimeter. And if you specify 116 millimeter, it's going to be tough for constructor, right? Most of the time you may say 110 or 100, but you cannot say, Ajahn, the S is 120 millimeter. You cannot say that, but you can say this is can be 110 is okay, or even 100 millimeter is going to be okay. So in practical, we may say the spacing is going to be 100 millimeter. And since the shear on this section is only 5 kilonewton, the shear on this one is 15 kilonewton. The 15 kilonewton, you do the spacing for 100. So for a smaller shear, the spacing going to be larger. The number of bolt is smaller. The spacing is larger. And they are T times different, right? Because V max is
15. We mean is 5 is 3 times. So they said the spacing for the BC can be 300. Okay, or you can do the proportion like this. And then the result is like this. On the AC is the pink. The spacing is 100 millimeter. For the BC, the red bow spacing for 300 millimeter. And there is the other design example. I will talking about it on chapter 11 or problem number 3. Okay, and then for the time being, let me take 5 minutes break and we will come back with the chapter 8. Coming back again on chapter 8. Okay, we talking about the combined loading, and then the main point of the combined loading is going to be able to determine the state of stress in two dimension. Okay, we have it in the previous example. And next of this chapter, we will focus on 3D structure. Okay, and then I put this one into the example, and there is the reaction occur on this portion of the structure basis on the axis of X, Y, and C. Okay, and then as I tell you, A sub C is going to be the normal force, and V sub Y, A sub Y by A is going to be the shear force V sub Y, and the A sub X is going to be the shear force of V sub X, and the shear force V sub X and V sub Y is transverse shear. We will have tau equal to VQ over IT. Okay, and then for this one is the normal force. So normal force will sigma equal to N over A. That's from chapter 4. And again, we also have the bending moment that's occur on this one. And this one, when it may be subjected to different kind of loading, this call M sub X and this call M sub Y. The stress M sub X, M sub Y will determine from sigma equal to MY over I. And there is torsional stress. This is going to be on the chapter 5. It's going to occur due to the moment about C axis. And this is going to tau equal to VQ over IT. So typically in our real world structure, the structure always subjected to the combined loading, and then it will produce internal forces and internal moment, and it's going to have various stresses. That is our duty to do the combination of the stress and write the stress distribution and the stress element. So again, let me take you back to the example in a very quick way. We have about 20 minutes, and let us work on this one. This is a frame, and this frame is three-dimensional frame. And as I mentioned, the first step that we need to determine is going to be the internal forces and internal moment. And then we use various equation to determine normal stress and shear stress. And this one is subjected to 100 kilonewton force over here. And what they asked us first, the free body diagram of the section AA. Section AA is the section over here. And Ajahn also provide you with this portion. And then as I mentioned, we need to determine internal force and bending moment. So the very first step, we will the free body diagram of the frame and determine what so called internal force that is going to be normal force and shear force and also internal moment. And let's see, this problem is easier than what I just mentioned. Basis upon this one, we will not have torsion. And I should say, most of the time, when the section is square or rectangular, we will not have the tau equal to TR over J. Why? Because chapter 5 talking about the shaft, all the shaft must be that we circle, right? So for this kind of problem, most of the time we didn't use chapter 5. So the main thing gonna be chapter 4, chapter 6, and chapter 7 to be included in this one. And basis upon this, if you take a look at this one, this frame have the axis of symmetry. This also another important point. Most of the time, the frame must be in symmetry. So when you take a look at this one, you may draw the top portion of the frame easily. 500 millimeter, just put this one to be 50 millimeter. So we may say we use scale of 1 millimeter per 10 millimeter. And then this is 200. So this is 20. And then you have this one 100 and 200. So you have this one 100, okay, to be 10. And this is 20. And then for this one equal to 300. So you put this one and this one going to be the same as this one to be 300 millimeter. And this is 100 millimeter. And this is 200 millimeter. This is 500 millimeter. This is 200 millimeter. And then you can draw the line here. That is going to be what? 500 minus 300. This is going to be 200 millimeter. And this is 200. This is 300. You will get this one to be 100 millimeter. Okay. And then there is a dashed line here. You just put the dashed line like this one. And then this is the point where the force acts upon it. The force F is by the ratio of 4 on the vertical and 3 on the horizontal. So you get this force to be 100 kilonewton. Then you may set up the axis like X and Y over here. What we have next, this section is rectangular. So we may set there supposed to be a point on this section and this point supposed to be the centroid. And if this one, the centroid, when you project is down over here, is supposed to separate this one to be 150 and 150 millimeter. So basis upon this one, you will have 1, 2, and 3. This one as the centroid of the section. Then when you get the centroid, and you may recall what we have from the 3 dimension, you reduce it into only 2 dimension. So under the application of the force, we have the force over here to be what? The ratio is 4, 3, 5. So this one is going to be 100 times 4/5. This is 4/5. And this also another component of the force is 100 time this one horizontal time 3 over 5. So based upon this, you guys will have the vertical. So we need to have this one as the normal force. And also for this one, we are supposed to have this one as the shear force. And then if you take moment at the centroid, the force will rotate in clockwise direction. So for sure, this one will have the bending moment M. See, we involve only for three main chapter, 4, 6, 7, and include to be number 8. And again, the problem asks you to determine the internal force and moment over here. So you got to take a look at this one, and the portion here going to have the length here of 300. So just put it over here. So you have this one as the bottom portion of this one. And also the projection for this one, this is going to be the centroid. And the support here is the fixed support. So you may put it in the model like this. This is going to be the fixed support. And then the end is going to be this one. The shear is going to be this one. And the moment is going to be this one. And based upon this, we can determine the summation of x sub x equal to 0. First, we will need to consider this one first. And later, we will use the Newton third law to find NVM over here. And then we will draw it over here. So based upon this one, summation of x sub x equal to 0. This is positive. So V is going to be equal to 100 times 3 over 5. So this is going to be 60 kilonewton. So this is going to be 60 kilonewton. And then if you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0, upward is positive. N is upward. This one equal to 100 times 4 over 5. So this is 80 kilonewton. So the N is going to be 80 kilonewton for the normal force. And for the moment, you do the summation of M about centroid equal to 0 and follow counterclockwise direction is positive. M is going to be this force times this distance. That is going to be equal to 80. The distance here is going to be from here to here is 150. From here to here is 200. So 0.35 meter, 350 millimeter. And then there is another one here, rotate in the same direction. Plus this is 60. The distance from the line of action of this force into this point is going to be 100. And this is half, it's going to be another 100. So the distance here is going to be 200 times 0.2. So the M can be equal to 40 kilonewton meter. Now, this is going to be the M of 40 kilonewton meter. Again, you need to convert from 2D into 3D. The shear, okay, 60 kilonewton is going to be on this section. And then you say, this is the shear of V equal to 60 kilonewton. And then for the compression, for the end, it's going to be the compression. So this is going to be N, and N is going to be 80 kilonewton. And the last one is the moment. So you got to the this one, or if you don't like it, you may the kit to be the moment in this direction. It's going to be the same, okay? And this one is going to be 40 kilonewton meter. Now, the section that we just consider will subjected to two forces and bending moment, and based upon this, you use the knowledge that we just mentioned from previous lecture, or we just mentioned on the start of this lecture. We will have what? The normal force N of 80 kilonewton will produce the normal stress distribution like this one. So next, we will what? We will also call the stress distribution on section we call it AA. Okay, so the stress here is due to this one, sigma equal to 80 kilonewton, that's 80,000 newton, and then it must divide by the cross sectional area, and this is 200 and this is 300. It's going to be divided by 200 and 300 millimeter square. So based upon this, you will get this one, 1.33 megapascal, and it is in compression. And then for next, we have the moment. Also, the moment produce the normal stress. That is going to be sigma equal to my over I. And based upon this one, there is the centroid that we locate over here. And since the moment is rotated in this direction, so compression will be here. So you just put the compression like this. And on this one, it's supposed to be in tension. And then you made the stress distribution of this problem. The first portion is in compression. This one is in tension. So sigma is going to be 40,000 newton meter. And then you got to measure on this one. That is 150 millimeter. Or this one is the same, 150 millimeter. So Y max is going to be 0.15 meter. And then it must divided by the moment of inertia. What kind of moment of inertia going to be used? It's going to be moment of inertia of this axis. If you use this axis, moment of inertia will be equal to this one, 0.2, and this one, 0.3 cube divided by 12. So you will get this one to be like 450 and 10 minus 6 meter power 4. So when you put it, it's going to be 450 and 10 minus 6 millimeter power 4. You get the stress over here to be 4.4 megapascal, and they are equal. And the last one is the shear. The shear stress is going to be in this direction, and again, it's going to be max on the centroid. So based upon this one, again, you may draw the stress distribution on the section like this. This is zero, this is zero, and this is going to be tau max. Okay, this tau max again is going to be what? 1.5 VOA. If อาจารย์ didn't say anything. If อาจารย์ said you're going to use VQ over IT, so it's going to be the area here. So 60,000 Newton max time what? This is 150. This is 200. 0.15 and 0.2. And the distance from here to here is half of 150. So it's going to be 0.075. Okay. And then you got to divide it by A, 450, 10 minus 6, and I. I is going to be the width over here, 0.2 meter. So you're supposed to get tau max to be 1.5 megapascal. For a simple equation, it's going to be 1.5, 60,000, and then divided by 200 and 300 square millimeter. You're supposed to get the same result. Okay, this is 60,000 cut 1.5 megapascal. It's going to be the same. And then this is the first thing. Again, the second thing, they ask us to determine the stress at the point over here. Okay, that means they ask us to determine the stress at this point, 100 millimeter. So for this one, you will have the stress that is only 50 millimeter. And also this one for 50 millimeter and this one for 50 millimeter. So based upon this compression, right? And this is tension. This stress going to be 1.333. If you determine the stress over here, it's going to be sigma equal to 40,000. Now the distance is only this one, 0.05, and then divided by 450, and then 10 minus 6. This is going to be what am doing something wrong? Yes, the result over here is not 4.4. The result over here supposed to be 13.33. Sorry, this is going to be 13.33, but this one will be 4.44 megapascal. And also the shear over here, tau is going to be 60,000 Newton. And then the location is over here. You got to this section again. This is going to be your neutral axis. And this is going to be 200. 200 is going to be the width here. And also you got to have this area. Actually, that is going to be 100. And then you can determine this one. This is going to be over here is 50. Over here is going to be 50. So it's going to be 0.2 times 0.1. This 0.2 times 0.1. And the moment arm is going to be 0.1. And then divided by I. And then T. T is going to be this one, 0.2. So tau is going to be 1.33 megapascal. Then the shear is going to put in this direction. This is 1.33 megapascal. And that is the other shear occur here. And then this is compression. This is tension. Tension is larger than compression. So this is going to be 4.44 minus 1.33. You get this one, 3.11 megapascal. This is going to be sigma sub y. and this is going to be tau sub x y. That's all for today.